Yellow group is meeting in the tech library to review the latest performance data.
Yellow group is seated in the tech library. Well, I'm going to skip that because it's time once again for Chris Boy's Grandpa Games, where we are doing a completely custom mission I created called the Battle of Turkana. Now, Star Wars nerds will know that this is a battle that is based off of a cutscene from the very first X-Wing game, and originally it was supposed to be like the Rebel Alliance's very first victory right before the Battle of Endor, where they got the plans. And then the game Dark Forces came out, and nope, we're gonna retcon that. And then Rogue One came out, and nope, we're gonna retcon that. You know, there are just so many stories about how the Death Star's plans fell into the Rebel Alliance's hands. Whatever, it's still a cool mission because it is the first time that the X-Wing Starfighter saw major combat, and it was a big fleet engagement between Mon Calamari cruisers of the Rebel fleet and entire fleet of Imperial Star Destroyers, and it is a lot of fun. Let's do it right now. So, Come in, dude. Sweet. Alright. Just do our customary looking around at the gorgeous hangar provided by the X-Wing Alliance Upgrade Project. It is so beautiful. I love it. So, I have 7 Mon Calamari Star Cruisers and a few support ships. Going up against the Imperial fleet that should be arriving shortly. That is my tanker ship. Oh no, unidentified craft. I really wish I had time to voice act out all this stuff. He collided with the Defiance back there. That usually doesn't happen. I guess he was following me or something. Wish I had changed that from waypoints before. But yeah, not usually something.
Hey, 2,
Great.
Attacking craft dead ahead.
So the TIE interceptors are a little bit too fast for us. Too fast. Ultra fast, lightning fast, ultra pointed. Oh boy. Look at all those Star Destroyers.
This is 3. I'm under heavy fire. This is 1. I'm under heavy fire.
I got 10 of them. And they are angry.
Hey,
mission where I got too many crap. My poor little computer can't quite handle it. So again, this is like the first real engagement where the Imperial fleet is introduced to the X-Wing. The X-Wing was created by the Incom Corporation, and it was about to be federalized, and they didn't want that. And so they defected with the plans for the X-Wing for the Rebel Alliance, and these are some of the first ships. Wedge Antilles actually fought in this mission, and he got his first 3 kills here in an X-Wing before he was shot down somehow and had to bail out. I don't know how Rebel pilots survived being shot down. You know, they're in space, and they do not have enclosed spacesuits, because we need to be able to see the heroes' faces when we're talking. You know, they can't be wearing spacesuits like some nameless Imperial pilot who's only known by his number.
Hey, Sue, keep your distance.
Imperial training does seem a bit lax. It's almost like they have millions of these guys that they are training every single year. I don't know how the Imperial fighting strength is. Academy on Cardia is just like out of control busy. Are there other Imperial Academy worlds, or is it just Cardia? Not entirely sure. Wow, these new X-Wings are incredible! The TIEs don't seem to chance! That's why you don't want me voice acting it. I'm just gonna put like some crazy voice to it. Command here. I just want to clean that up. Look at all those Mon Calamari cruisers. Should take crazy evasive action. It took me so long to program those Mon Calamari cruisers to take realistic-looking evasive action without crashing into one another. And still stay in, like, you know, some sort of formation. Yeah! So, I got 3 squadrons of Y-Wings and 2 squadrons of X-Wings against just a massive amount of guys. Come on. Die, Jim. Good shooting. Really crappy shooting. It took so long just to like get those ships not to collide. But I'm really happy with how this this mission actually turned out. That was an unfortunate time for the 5X. There's a bandit on your tail! Don't worry, I got it. Turn Star Destroyer AI way down, because if you have all the Star Destroyers on normal AI, they just completely crush the rebel for you. You know? Like, they made these Star Destroyers so powerful. They made these Star Destroyers so powerful that they gave the Rebel Fleet, in the movies anyway, and the shows, special plot armor to keep them from being blown out of the water. Alright, that is the end of the tides. I love it. We got Defiance and Dauntless. Both hitting this one Star Destroyer is my objective. And standard anti-Star Destroyer objectives. Going for shield generator. Vectoring in. destroyers destroyed. Then the rest of the fleet is going to bug out. I will never understand why the rebel, why the rebel fleet's turbo lasers only fire at like, I don't know, 1/3 the rate of, the Imperials. Like, if I have the Imperials turned up to normal, things utterly slaughter the rebel fleet. It is just no contest whatsoever. Like, the plot armor of the Rebel fleet in the shows is non-existent in this game. So, like, you have to dump down these armor shooters. Which is why I'm able to get away with bullshit like this. I have a couple of the Star Destroyers set for normal AI. They're shooting a lot, but I put those two Star Destroyers out on the very edges of the launch. Are hiding down the area.
This is 8, vectoring in.
Not the best explosion sequence ever.
Let's get five. Have the Imperial fleet. Let's go for five.
We let one get away.
Come on, boys. We gotta get him.
Get him though. Still might get five of them. I think he's the last one. Oh no, one more. Oh, yep, no, we got five! Five of them.
I'm losing it!
Yeah. The Independence.
My shields are going. This is 6. I'm under heavy fire.
Mr. 7, we can't take him. Mr. 7, I'm losing it!
We let one get away.
It's a lot of fun to play. Good dog fighting. A lot of anti-starfighter action. And then going after the Star Destroyers. The first great Rebel victory that we never really get to hear about because they keep on retconning everything in Star Wars. And getting new writers who are worse than the writers before. Alright, thank you so much for watching to this point, if indeed you have. This is Chris Boy's Grandpa Games, and I will see you next weekend.